some good news. I've got a few bits of good news, actually. You will see on the channel that I did a couple of videos about credit card debt and council tax, and you know how to deal with all this, you know, where it becomes an issue. And I did a live stream particularly on the actual credit card side of things, as in if it goes to a debt collector, what you do, the three letter process and everything else. Well, I've been dealing with a couple of cases at the moment, and I received this today from Cabot Financial. That's one of the main debt buyers. They're called debt collectors, but they're debt buyers. And this is dated a couple of days ago. Listen to this. Mr. Andy the Gabby Cabby, your account is no longer with our solicitors. It's been returned to Cabot Financial. You don't need to do anything, and no further action will be taken to collect your outstanding balance. That's a good one, isn't it? Now, the reason is, with this whole business, they're not going to take any further action to recover my balance, is because I asked them three times to prove that they're legally entitled to collect that balance. They failed to produce that evidence three times. I then reported them to the Financial Services Ombudsman, who investigated it, and they upheld their side of things and not mine, because the Financial Services Ombudsman isn't worth the paper it's written on. They kept hassling me, and I told them to get knotted, so they decided to take me to court with this one. So again, I went through the civil procedure rules, where you go on the fact that you're entitled to sight of everything, with you know, that you're entitled to in order to form an adequate defence. So again, you ask them three times, I want to see the information that tells me that you can legally pursue me for this debt. Three times they fail, because the main thing is you need something called a deed of assignment, which is the document that shows that the account was legally, and the right to collect it as well, legally transferred from the original bank or credit card over to the debt collector. And they won't show you that because it doesn't exist. They don't have it actually on paper to prove that they can, so they never will. So when the three times fails, what you do, you write into the court and you say, can you please put a note on the file, which will point out that, you know, I've asked them and asked them and asked them and they've not done it. And then it may get transferred to the actual local county court where you live, and you just write to the judge and say, look, I want to save your time here, not done this, bosh. Please order them to produce it, and if they haven't, kick the claim out. Now, it can get that far. It really can get that far, and they can end up kicking the claim out. But every now and again, these debt buyers will actually realise that they're biting off their nose to spite their face, which will happen in this case. Now, Cabot Financial actually have another account of mine, and we're going through the same process again. Now, what they've done here as well, they've set precedent. They've actually set precedent, and I'm willing to allow anybody to quote this in their own issues, whereby they will just get rid of it if they can't prove it. It becomes more hassle in both, you know, time and money. So there you go. It's